brought a warning. But we weren't ready to listen.
What was the warning?
Water.
They put something in the water?
Yes.
So that's it? War fought by poisoning the water.
It was more subtle than poison. Female hormones.
So they intend to wipe us all out by making us sterile?
You forget they use living things, they don't destroy them.
They're feminizing us. Gradually, all human beings will be female.
Specimen 01.
These animals that we know are genetic males have been exposed to atrazine for their entire life. And many of these genetic males now are turning into females. You can see he's got eggs that kind of look like they're in a sack. These are actually yolked eggs ready to be laid. What's happening is you're skewing sex ratios. You can get genetic bottlenecking, which can cause crashes. And quite frankly, if you're a genetic male, it'd be nice if you developed as a genetic male. And now we have a chemical very common in the environment that's effectively sex reversing animals.
I'm going to show you something pretty amazing, scientifically speaking. The one that's sort of remarkable is this pair. These are both males. The one on the bottom, acting as the female, we affectionately refer to as Darnell. He's a genetic male that not only acts like a female, he lays eggs like a female.
Kill me, I'm here! Come on, do it now, kill me!
He, she, has been exposed to atrazine all of her life. I don't even really know how to reference it. This is Darnell's third clutch. So Darnell has sons and daughters that we've grown up. You can see eggs in the bottom. This is actually her second clutch for today. She has been copulating for getting close to 24 hours now.
Come on!
This is the most common contaminant in ground and surface water and drinking water. And the level of atrazine that it took to make this male turn into a female is 3 times less than what's allowed in our drinking water.
I really think that the global amphibian decline is telling us something about human health.
The toxins in our waters are reaching well beyond frogs. Reproductive abnormalities have been reported in everything from alligators to polar bears to humans.
It's not just a problem with frogs we should be concerned about. The water that's causing their problems is the same water that we're drinking and using to water our crops.
Frog or human, we all breathe the same air and drink the same water. For their sake and ours, experts agree, we have to take action, and there's no time to lose.